Hello, veteran Owen Twin here. Welcome back, and this is another episode of Final Fantasy VI. In the last episode, Relm caught herself on fire, and then she proceeded to catch this entire mansion on fire. Damn kids. I tell ya. So, we gotta go find her now, and we gotta avoid all the perils of running around in a burning building. We don't get any fire suits, no oxygen masks, nothing. And we gotta fight some freaking bombs or whatever the hell these things are called. And yeah, Strago, he has lore abilities. He actually starts out with Revenge Blast, which I believe does damage based on the amount of HP he's lost. I could be wrong about that. But yeah, I'm gonna use Aqua Breath on these guys. That should take them out. It's pretty damn good. Yeah, I have the Ifrit Esper equipped on Strago so he can start working on fire spells. And yeah, there's a lot of fire enemies in this place. If you have the Ice Brands equipped, you can do okay damage, I guess, against these guys. I'm just going to try and use Aqua Breath as much as I can here, though. I mean, if I gotta use ethers, I gotta use ethers. Not a big deal. Yeah, I gotta fight this one. Yeah, these battles should go pretty quick. The only thing I recommend doing is watch your levels. Know when you're going to level up. Like with Terra, I mean, I still want her to work on Ramu, but at the same time, actually, hold on. How are you doing on this? Okay, yeah. I want to move you to a different Esper because I can learn Thundara faster on Maduin than I could ever do it on Ramu, which, again, I'm going to keep saying that. Doesn't make any sense. But whatever, that's just the way they did it. Another skill for Strago fighting those guys, they use... you know what, I might as well just learn it right now. I think what you have to do is cast like a weak fire spell on them, like one time, and then they'll use it. And I'll cast it on that one. We'll see what happens here. Or maybe not. Well, I don't know then. I'll just use Blizzard, I guess. Yeah, I was thinking you had to, like, use fire on them, and then they would use Exploder. I'll be able to learn it later anyways, and it's not that great of an ability as it is, so not really a high priority, but just know that you can learn a lore for Strago from those guys. Yeah, I probably got one more battle before I'm gonna have to switch here. Yeah, I wanted to work on Blizzard before with Terra, that way she'd be good to go for this place. Can help out too with taking all these bombs. Now, I believe if we go in that first door there, it's actually going to be on a trap. So don't bother. I think. Pretty sure. Don't quote me on it, but I'm pretty sure. So I'm going to skip it. But as long as I find a one flame rod and one blizzard rod in this place, then we're good. Okay, yeah, I need to switch you over to Zana Seeker, because I might as well. A plus two is better than a plus one. And I keep running into all these guys. I don't think they're avoidable. Just gonna have to fight them all. Okay, so Tara, okay, Straggle's about to gain a level. Tara already gained a level, so I'm going to put her back on Madeline so she can keep working on Thundara. And then Straggle, I'm going to put you on Zona Seeker. That way you can get a nice plus 2 magic bonus for this level. That you're about to get. Wow, his speed is really slow. Yay! Alright. Let's switch you back over to... What am I having you again? Ifrit? Yeah. Want him to learn Fira as fast as possible. Alright, so over here, and we can get a chest with a flame rod. And then through here, I'm going to go to the right again. And we get another chest with an ice rod, which is going to be very, very nice very soon. Oh, man. Thought I snuck past that guy there. As you can see, these battles, they go pretty quick. As long as you're beefed up and you have some nice spells already. So yeah, definitely as soon as you get Tara back in your party, start working on Blazara. That way you're not totally reliant on Strago's lores for this place. Okay, through here is basically... Yeah, I might as well heal up. Might as well heal up, get to full strength. Go through here, and, okay, really? I thought Relm started the blaze. I thought she caught on fire, and then she caught the house on fire. I mean, something else actually caused this? What the hell? And we gotta fight a flame eater. Okay, let's fight a flame eater. First of all, let's steal from this guy, and apparently I can't steal from this guy. Yeah, I'm going to use Aqua Breath to thin the enemy lines here. Get rid of those fucking bombs or whatever they are. Alright, we can steal Flame Tongue. I'm going to go ahead and Trance Terra now. And go to Items. Go all the way down. All the way down, wherever the hell it is. There it is. And I'm going to go ahead and use this ice rod on this bastard. And what do you know? He brings a couple guys back. What kind of bullshit move is that? But look at that. Quadruple 9 damage. If you kill the boss, it automatically kills his spawn. So there you go. That is your first taste of the awesomeness of Tara. I mean, she really is amazing. Didn't seem like it in the beginning of the game, but she's really good. And wow, look at that. Interceptor's a really good dog. But it doesn't matter because we're all dead. Oh, wait, maybe we're not. Yeah, that's right. That's right, you sold those flames to his boss. Wow, nice job, man. Alright, just like that, we're out. Shadow saves the day. But really, he wouldn't have done that if it weren't for his dog. Maybe he would have. I don't know. Maybe Shadow just doesn't know, or maybe he does. Yeah, give the illusion of trials when they were just probably executing people. How is your Magi blood thinned? I mean, you guys have just known each other throughout all this time, right? I mean, right? So, I mean, I understand if you're breeding with outsiders that aren't magic users that the blood would thin, but if you're just breeding with each other, then wouldn't it stay strong as ever? Whatever, I'm sorry, I'll shut up now. I think not, young lady. Oh, come on, just let her come along. Fuddy-duddy. You know what, I think they took that line out of the GBA Advance version, or whatever, Advance version of the game. So yeah, I'm glad they put that back in. Because I don't think she says fuddy-duddy in that version of the game. What, now she's over in the corner pouting or something? I mean, and then Shadow runs off? Okay. What a fuddy-duddy. I don't know, for some reason humorous. Alright, what's up, Shadow? You aren't gonna go with us? You have your dog back. He's still loyal to you. He's just also loyal to somebody else, too. Oh no, don't take the doggy away! But yeah, it should get revealed later on why that dog has a very strong connection to Relm. But we won't find that out until later. Alright. So yeah, Strago, he can memorize spells that he sees monsters use. Oh, yeah, and if he's asleep or confused, he won't learn it. But yeah, the good thing about lore or blue magic in this game is as long as Strago can see the ability, he'll learn it. It's not like other Final Fantasy games where you need to have the ability used on the caster, and then they learn it. If he sees it or if it's used, he automatically learns it. As long as he's alive at the end of battle, he will learn the ability. And yeah, I already know about shattering rods, because I just did that. So yeah, that's why rods in this game are extremely broken. Because with the right characters, you can deal a ton of damage, as you just saw. I mean, hell, I dealt quadruple nines against that flame eater, that ice rod. So yeah, speaking of ice rods and rods in general, I want to pick up, don't know, three of these and a couple of these and some more ice rods as well, because they're pretty damn useful, I must say. Very, very useful. How am I doing on gill? Okay, I still got quite a lot of gill. As far as Strago's gear, I don't know if I mentioned what gear I put on him. Yeah, I could put something else on him now. I think I'll put a flame rod, I guess, on him. And yeah, I guess, I don't know, I don't remember. Can you learn spells from this? Oh, okay. Yeah, you can't learn the Bazaar spell from this weapon, but I believe the ice shields that you can find later on in the game are the items you can equip to actually learn the Bazaar spell from, if I'm not mistaken. But anyways, that's all for this episode of Final Fantasy VI. I guess that's not all. I guess we're gonna kill this guy first. I believe the correct line would be GAME? Yeah. Friggin' bullcrap. That's all for this episode of Final Fantasy VI. In the next episode, we're gonna head to the mountains in the west.